I mean, not anyone
special. You're just too picky, they all tell me.
Not like I ask.
But it's just that I have the sixth sense. I can't help it. I can just sniff out a lie. Take my best friend, Nan. My friend, Nan. Date Jean. I knew that it was doomed from the start. Jean owned laundromats, or so he said. Nan didn't care, as Jean was great in bed. But Jean turned out to be a bookie. The laundromat was where he laundered fats. Regrets, Jean got jailed.
As good as it gets, because you really are. I wanted to do dinner, but business meeting. So, how about that drink? Anything on tap is fine. You sure you don't mind?
Of course not. Truth be told, I love anything on tap. Jerry.
Oh, you can call me Glenn.
Why?
That's my name.
Say no more. Before, Glenn would have continued to let me think his name was Gary because he knew he'd go back online tonight to try to meet 20 new women. But now, with limited funds, he can't date as much. His buck stops here. So, tell me, Glenn, how's work going these days? Says you're a CMO at a major .com in Soho?
Well, Judy, actually, back in January, I kind of lost my...
Say no more. Nowadays, it's not what a person does for a living. It's what he used to do.
But I've been very busy looking for a new job.
Really? And how's that going?
Excellent. Not that I have anything solid yet, but I have some feelers out all over the place. I've been searching online, reviewing my resume, social networking, cultivating my transferable skills, going to job fairs.
That is wonderful, Glenn. You need to judge a man not for his job, but for how he conducts his job search. With all your effort, I'm sure something ideal will just fall right into your lap very soon.
Nice, Judy. I'm very supportive. So, how are things going for you?
Me? Used to be a man who talked all night about himself and his job. But with that one, he will actually turn the conversation back to you. Oh, I'm fine. Spanish teacher. Hablo español. And I teach where I went to high school, in Queens. Same old, same old.
Security. I like that.
You do? Oh, because some men have thought it, well, boring.
Boring? I'd say not.
Oh. Guess I'm just a creature of habit. Live in the same apartment for the last 20 years, too.
Where do you live? Manhattan or the boroughs?
True to say.
One bedroom.
Judy.
From the date that I wasn't able to roll over my 401k, I never again thought that I'd be able to roll over to a beautiful woman.
You think I'm beautiful?
Recession or not, a little flattery never hurts.
All those years I had money, but no time to really know someone. That's right, why 3 divorces?
It says here, 2.
Actually, 4. Gold diggers, all of them. But not you, Judy, the only woman to accept me, unemployed. Goes to show money can't buy you love.
Yeah, but it is a lot like sex. It's only a problem if it isn't there.
Not a problem.
Which?
Both. I'm virile and you're solvent.
I'm fired. Happened last week.
Judy, that's awful. I'm sorry. Very sorry to hear that. Well, I mean, you know now, things are different now.
Tell me about it.
What? I really hoped it would work. How can we date? I mean, somebody's gotta have a job, right? Yes, I thought that after this we'd catch a movie, but now I think we should hit up that pink slip happy hour party over at Grand Central.
Oh, Glenn, I feel so ashamed, but I lied. You may never forgive me. My job is safe. Only I had to be sure you really wanted someone to love, and not just somebody to share the stress with.
You had to downsize your dreams, I know. I tell you that has to end.
Really?
You should expect so much more from me. Yes, you're for me, sweet single friend. Bonds are bought and then they're sold. And when the world starts to tumble down, to find that someone to hold. Love in the time of recession.
Most of so much less love. in that time of recession.
Yeah.